Twitch is fixed. Why are you being cringe, dude? Nothing is fixed. Nothing was broken and nothing is fixed. But they did walk back some rules. You have this new thing on Twitter that they have added in. Readers added context they thought people might want to know about tweets. This is a good thing. So they have walked back some of it. Yesterday we released a new brand content guidelines that impacted your ability to work with sponsors to increase your
for fucking shit.
Sponsor to increase your income from streaming. These guidelines are bad for you and bad for Twitch, and we are removing them immediately. Readers added context they thought people might want to know. Twitch terms of service still state that Twitch users/streamers may not insert embedded advertisement and banner ads. This means, because I have been reading, we can still read the rest. Sponsorships are critical to streamers' growth and ability to earn income. We will not prevent your ability to enter into direct relationship with sponsors. You will continue to own and control your sponsorship business. We want to work with our community to create the best experience on Twitch. And to do that, we need to be clear about what we're doing and why we're doing it. We appreciate your feedback and help in making this change. You can read our new branded content policy here. What they did was what I expected. Because from what I saw, I think I mentioned this when we looked at this on Tuesday, is that they want to get rid of third-party website like like this one, where you can just sign up, log in, put an overlay on in your OBS, and they send out ads now and then. That's what they want to remove, because those pages is what they want to have removed, because they want to do that themselves, is my guess. But if I have a direct contact with a brand like Mad Monk, Ghost, Cyber Ghost VPN, that is still going to be allowed. So they didn't want to remove, like, me playing a video from Mad Monk. If I put on that video, that's not the issue. Seems like that limits smaller streamers' ability to grow without outside funding, kind of against the message they're spreading. I kind of agree with you, Winston. I don't see the reason. Ari, hello, hello. How are you doing? Literally, oh, there's a spider in the house. Let's fucking nuke the whole thing. I kind of agree with you guys that it wasn't the smartest decision. I think they should have not done this. How many times is Twitch going to mess up like this? Good question, because there is some new changes that is done. And I will show you. This guy, he writes a lot about branded content. Where is this new thing? He puts out the he has quote tweeted there. These are good words, and I'm glad they removed the documentation from the help article, but the same terminology remains in the terms of service. This needs to be removed or rewritten to "you may not." Feels like Twitch wants to get more and more control over streamers on Twitch. Twitch has the exclusive right to monetize the Twitch service, including, without limitations, the exclusive right to sell, serve, and display advertisement on the Twitch service. This means "you may not," nor may you allow a third party to insert or embed pre-recorded advertisement units into your live stream, including, without limitation, video advertisement, whether pre, mid, or post-roll, display, or banner advertisements, and audio advertisements. This means, as I said, that I can put ads, like I have them banners down in the corner, using them as example again, into my stream myself. But I can't just have an overlay that someone else, a third party site, controls. Seems it's just another tool to use their discretion for bans, maybe. Mic cable scuffed again. Is it scuffed now? I think this is to their plan. Just so they can remove third party site. I'm trying to find the other tweet that I was reading about the new partner contracts. Why can't I find that one anymore? Is it old? We need to look. They bought 4 dozen donut. I don't even know what that is. It should be here somewhere. Yes, this one. As of yesterday, Twitch partners are getting notification that there is a new contract. If they don't accept their partner contract, if they don't accept, their partner contract will be terminated at the next effective contract date, and they will be made into affiliates until they accept. All partners should consult a lawyer about the new contract. According to Twitch, here are the changes. Non-stream exclusivity. No, stream non-exclusivity. Better visibility of your agreement. Revenue share info on the dashboard. No set contract term. Streamer payment / US tax withholding. I saw a lawyer wrote a full article about this, but I can't find it right now. After launch of the update, terms of June 6th, 2023 will begin messaging 120 days. Because there are they're changing us up, and what from what I have been reading, we are going from being partners, new changes POG, to being on some the same terms as fucking affiliates, even though we are partners, and they're making a new contract that they can change much easier, is what I saw. But I can't find that article. There was a lawyer that wrote Twitch has been screwing partners for the past 2 years. Yes, it seems like they have. It is some weird things going on. At least they walked back most of the brand content TOS. Most of it, except third-party website, which I have to say doesn't affect me. At least I can play the Mad Monk ad right now. Since we're talking about brand deals, have you heard about Mad Monk chat? ! Mad Monk in chat. It's me and Forsen that enjoys these pills. If you ever... ever want to be as cool as Forsen, maybe you should take one. And No, but nice dick pills. Does it look like Forsen take the dick pills? Sitting there like a hobo in front of his computer doing Minecraft speedrun for 2 months straight? I don't think he takes much of them. But again, we had to look at the new terms. I have to be updated, and I can't take time to do it off stream, or I have actually done some research, a minimum amount of research.